What is listeriosis and why is so dangerous? Listeriosis is an infection caused by Listeria monocytogenes, which is a microorganism that has natural habitat in soils, in water, and in plants. If mainly immunocompromised people ingest foodstuff contaminated by this microorganism, we can have a serious disease with a very dangerous consequences such as hospitalization, abortion, and death. In order to understand how could be dangerous this disease, we can consider the European situation. According with a report published by two important health European organizations, in 2018, we confirm 2,549 cases of listeriosis in the European community, leading to 1,050 hospitalization. And from this 1,050 hospitalization, we had 58% of dead people. If we consider the 13 zoonoses listed in this survey, we know that there are four of them have a large amount of cases, but Listeria was the first in terms of dead people. So it's very dangerous. There is an important role of foodstuff in this disease because practically all the reported cases were linked with the ingestion of contaminated food. Not only fresh food as a fresh salad, but also cooked and pasteurized food. Because it's true that cooking and pasteurization at temperature higher than 65 degrees kill Listeria. But there is the possibility of recontamination, cross-contamination after the heat treatment. We have also to know that differently from other microorganisms responsible of foodborne disease, Listeria can tolerate high concentration of salt and can multiply, so can live and multiply also very low temperature between 2 and 4 degrees. Because of this resistance of Listeria and the high rates of mortality, mainly among immunocompromised people, practically all the national authorities have placed a limit on the presence of Listeria in the foodstuff. In particular, is very important the case of the United States. In this in United States, there is a tolerance zero, so zero tolerance for the presence of Listeria. This is a bigger issue, a bigger problem for the foreign company that want to export importation to the United States. In case of batch with the positivity of Listeria at level of custom, the producer must destroy the goods at their expenses, and also they are put in a list, a ban list, that can become a perennial in case of recurrence of positivity. So in order to avoid presence or large number of Listeria in foodstuff, the food producer should apply strictly the GMP, mainly regarding the hygiene of raw material and the hygiene of the surface in contact with the foodstuff. Another thing important is the control of the temperature, and we must pay attention to the microbiological quality of water. This main case of the fresh food like fresh salad. Other foodstuff very critical are what we call RTE food, the ready-to-eat. Because of their nature, RTE food can be consumed directly without any cooking before the consumption. Often this kind of food, an example are the sliced deli meat, are microbiologically modified during the cooking or during one pasteurization. But because of the following cross-contamination, can have threats of listeria on the surface. So we must put a lot of attention to the hygiene of surface, mainly because listeria can produce, can survive and produce biofilm. Since we began to discuss about the contamination of foodstuff from biofilm, we have known that listeria can survive in biofilm produced by other microorganisms like Pseudomonas, actually. But nowadays we know, and there is some recent study that discussed this case, we know nowadays that listeria itself is a promoter of biofilm. Moreover, as you can see in this chart, listeria can create biofilm in any kind of food surface. So in stainless steel, in plastic, in rubber, in all kind of gasket we can have in the food area. How we can do the biofilm prevention in order to prevent the contamination from listeria. Today, most of the proposals to solve the problem of biofilm are designed to prevent the maturation of biofilm. So, to prevent the biofilm to reach, to achieve one size so big that leads a sort of explosion of the biofilm with the contamination of liquid or powder, or generally speaking of foodstuff. But this model of biofilm is not updated. Nowadays, we know that microorganisms from biofilm can continuously contaminate the foodstuff. For this reason, the only way to prevent the contamination is to prevent the first stage of biofilm development. It means adhesion. How we can inhibit the adhesion of microorganisms on surface? First of all, we have to know that there are some substrates property that promote the adhesion. First of all is the defect of the irregularity of the surface that obviously protect the microorganisms from the liquid sanification or cleaning solution, and also the presence at the end of the cleaning operation on the surface of organic molecule or cations. It turns out that only cleaning solution, a disinfecting solution containing a large amount, proper amount of surfactant and sequestering agent are useful to prevent the adhesion. So, to summarize, when we draw up sanitation procedure, we have to consider that the microorganism can anchor on the surface only if on the surface we have traces of organic ingredient and mineral deposit. Only solution containing sequestering agent and surfactant agent prevent the deposits. And these are concepts derived from the thermodynamic law. So they are valid all over the world. There is not food plants that escape to this condition. Washing operation performed with the simply caustic solution, for instance, the solution only of caustic soda, are not effective in preventing the adhesion.